Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Oh, come on. Good morning. Woo! All right. Today's focus is fundamental two, as you all know, inclusive practices. You'll have a chance to look through your data profiles today, looking at climate data, and that will help you fine-tune how inclusive practices are done at your school. As Debbie mentioned, for the first time ever, we're excited to bring you Ed Talks, where you'll have a chance to see examples of great inclusive practices. And the best part about them is that they are all homegrown. They're what we do in our school district every day. Last night, we had our zoning committee meeting, and that is thankfully run by, where's Paul? Paul is over here. He helps to run that committee meeting. We have members from all over the Truckee Meadows. We have a school district representative on there. Where is Joel? I'm Trainer. Is Joel here? Joel sits on there as our school district representative. So we wanted to make sure that you all understood the purpose of the Green Zoning Committee. As you know, we are going to have two new middle schools opened up in 2019, and one elementary school. And that is all part, thankfully, to WC1. So we need to start the zoning process now. And so when we start talking about the rezoning of two middle schools and one elementary school, there are going to be ripple effects on how those schools are rezoned. And so even though we're just talking about the three schools, it actually is going to be far more encompassing as far as the schools that show the impact, and it's all good news. Because as we open up these new schools, that allows for sixth graders to transition into the middle schools, which therefore opens up classroom space in our elementary schools. So we want to make sure that you, as the practitioners at our schools, as the leaders of our schools, have that information right there in front of you. Because who is going to be asked the questions? You all are going to be asked the questions from your parents and from your teachers. So today in your area time, you're going to get, and just like we talked about with our high schools, preliminary in red, this is preliminary. What you see on this piece of paper does not mean what it's going to happen. Nothing is going to happen until the board makes its final decision, and it is a fast timeline. We are talking about bringing this to the board in April or May of 2018 so that our families have plenty of time to understand which school they will be going to. But you will see how some of the ideas are laying out as far as when we're starting to talk about rezoning. So it's important to get that information out to you now so that you are well informed, and if you have any questions, you can bring them to Paul. Or your area superintendent, of course.